back in August 2018, we had a serious incident where one of our drills basically trammed over the edge of a high wall. The operator was concentrating on the GPS screen at the time and not looking at outside the cab, and really lost his bearings in the dark on night shift. It was a serious incident. Certainly lucky that the drill got bogged or dry bogged on the Windrow and prevented the actual drill from going over the edge of the high wall. Look, if that had occurred, that drill would have fallen some 50 odd metres down to the pit floor and almost certainly would have been a fatality of that operator on board.
Engineering solutions are basically always the goal we're looking for. We'll never remove human behaviour, and that's always the biggest risk on in any workplace, because it's something you can't control. But when you introduce an engineering standard that can prevent the worst outcome, then absolutely. And that's what this is. It's basically a brilliant engineering standard that will prevent a drill walking off a high wall edge. So health and safety is basically our number one priority every single day.
The incident at Bulga was a repeat incident for the industry. It needed to be solved in a way that was going to be a permanent solution that would prevent reoccurrence across any other site in any sort of situation.
The majority of the controls we do have in place for fatal type incidents are still relying on admin controls that are relying on humans being effective. The guys have come up with a solution that's an engineering control, so it takes the human completely out of the equation. Now, if we can get this on many more of our other hazards, then it's just going to be a much safer operation for us, and the whole industry will benefit from it.
There's a switch on each corner of the machine positioned in front of the tracks that are designed to be operated if they come into contact with the Windrow. Those switches, through like an e-stop safety relay, will cut out tram function to the machine. So the engine will still run, but you'll lose tram function and you won't be able to continue over that Windrow. It's a proximity switch that you can buy off the shelf, but we had to modify we call it the wand that attaches to the end of the switch. There were no products available that met our needs, so we worked with a local company to design the wand for the end of the switch. It was like a lot of moving pieces in the final design to sort of get the heights and the lengths and positions right, but I think in the end we come up with a pretty successful solution.
Well, this was the drill that was involved in the incident, so it potentially would be the bottom of the pit in a pile covered with dirt at the moment if we weren't as lucky as we were on the night. And then having the solution that we have installed on the drill means that it'll continue to work for us and be a safe asset for the operators until Bulga closes.
Now, the guys have just done a great job. We had a couple of our representatives from Bulga here present to the Mine Managers Association this time last year to really get that knowledge out there. Glencore have also presented the findings of this across all our sites around the globe as well. And it's these sort of innovations that will help us improve health and safety into the future.